Now, they say laughter is the best medicine, and a brand new book filled with great jokes will do more than just make you laugh. It could help save a life. All proceeds from the Bloke-asaurus joke book will be going to men's mental health charity Gotcha for Life, and the book was written by the Worland brothers, the gorgeous Gus from Triple M Sydney and best-selling author Steve, and they're both with us this morning. Hello! Yeah.
Hello. Thanks for having us.
Who's the funniest brother?
I think just talking and chatting, I've got him covered.
Yes.
But in terms of writing and so forth, he's absolutely brilliant, my brother. So it was great to do something together and to do something for such a wonderful cause that's been a big part of our family now for quite a few years.
And Gussie, as you know, you two aren't the only funny blokes on the panel. I'm a bit partial to a dad joke myself. Do you guys have a favourite dad joke? I know that these days we just call them jokes.
But... Steve's the main man when it comes to that, but I will tell you that a lot of people that have had the book, it's been out a couple of days, have said to us that the lamest jokes are the ones they love the most because they can embarrass their kids with them.
Oh, yeah.
And that is our main focus.
Yeah, it's embarrassing your kids or embarrassing your kids with their friends around, which is always fantastic.
Even better. Yeah. Like, I'm still one of those dads that drives down the street and beeps to a stranger and waves, and they sort of wave,
good
and
then
everyone goes, what was that for? And I go, I don't know, I just wanted to...
Right. Yeah.
Well, you're driving along on the northern beach, you go, do you know where the beach is? And you're literally right next to that. I'm still... And the kids are like, it was funny 10 years ago, now they're teenagers.
It's your job as a dad to torture your kids. That's what you're supposed to do.
That's exactly right.
Yeah. So I like to see it as the cycle of abuse. My parents did it to me, and by God, I'm going to do it to my children.
Exactly right.
Now, guys, the book is going towards a very good cause. Can you tell me a little bit more about your charity, Gotcha for Life?
Yeah, so Gotcha for Life was started off the back of a program I did on the ABC about 18 months ago called Man Up. And that was challenging masculinity in this country. Trying to live up to a stereotype of an Aussie bloke is impossible. Mm. We're losing 6 beautiful Aussie blokes every single day to suicide. It's the number one way to lose your life.
Sorry, did you say 6 a day?
6 a day, and it's the number one way, Sarah, for an Aussie man to lose his life if he's between 15 and 44 years of age.
That's horrific.
So we need to change what the rules are that make up what a man is. And Gotcha for Life has got schools programs, so we're telling young kids, and also a real focus around men answering phones at Lifeline, because when a man rings Lifeline and he gets a girl or a lady, he hangs up. And it takes so much to get them to make that phone call. So now we've got over 100 blokes in scholarships paid for by Gotcha, so blokes can end up being on those lines.
You mentioned school. Steve, when you were both at school, you were taught boys don't cry and you've got to be hard, you've got to be tough.
Yeah.
How do you turn that perception around?
It's just a long process of talking and getting them to open up and, you know, with Gus's Gotcha for Life Foundation, they've got people going into schools trying to engage boys to talk about how they feel.
Yeah.
And it's a long and difficult process, but so far has been very successful.
It's been great. The thing about it is that the boys will talk if you give them a safe environment to do so.
Right.
And that's been proven. We've had so many wonderful nights just down on the northern beaches in Sydney and Avalon. It was a horrible night about 3 Mondays ago. 256 blokes turned up at Avalon Surf Life Saving Club and sat in silence as men stood up and had a conversation of real gravity, a conversation of honesty and vulnerability. And you sit there and you go, this is a movement that we all want to get behind.
Yeah.
We just have to be kind to each other and allow us to have the space to have the convo.
Yeah.
So all the money's going to go to those causes.
What is it that's leading men to these really dark places? Obviously, everyone's different, but what are some of the main themes that you're seeing?
I think trying to live up to a stereotype of an Aussie bloke that's impossible.
Right.
It was a whole set of rules set up so many years ago that us young blokes now, my son 18, he just doesn't understand it. Why does he have to be this certain way?
Yeah.
They're confused and they don't have the skills to have the conversation. So our schools programs are all about giving them those tools that they need to be able to turn around and say, things aren't going well for me. Can you help me, please?
You've been doing some mental health workshops in schools along with former Aussie cricket captain Steve Smith, who has had a hell of a year.
He has.
First of all, how is he doing? Because he looked like a broken man at that press conference that he gave, and it was heartbreaking to watch. How's he doing first?
I think I'd say, Sarah, the first month or so from that moment on, because I think he knew when he broke down in Sydney, and you're seeing the vision there, that was Steve Smith. That was true. That was what he was about.
Yep.
He didn't quite realise the size of the drama when it happened in South Africa. Once that happened, he needed a lot of people around him. He needed to connect with his wife, fiance, with his manager, with all his best mates. They've got around him. I've gone into schools with him and people have stood up and given him a standing ovation.
Yeah.
He's needed it as much as the kids have needed it.
Yeah.
But he stood up and he's been vulnerable, he's been honest, he's been lovely, and it's made him appreciate, oh, my goodness, I didn't realise how important this work actually is. We went to his old school. Within 2 hours of us leaving, I had a phone call from the headmaster and two boys had come into the school principal and said, I want to talk to you about how I feel. I'm not feeling well. I was thinking of harming myself.
Oh, wow.
That's amazing. Now, we do know that both of you went to school with Hugh Jackman.
Mm.
Somehow, Gus, you ended up best mates with him, Steve.
Yes. Not... Well, no, they were in the same year together.
Oh, yeah. Is that
Steve's
why?
Older.
Yeah, yeah, I'm
as you can, as you can tell.
I'm a bit older. Please.
But, of course, so Hugh ends up in the book. Now,
yeah.
I think he once made the mistake of giving you his credit card.
I've still got it. what are you doing for lunch?
Oh, I'm available. Yeah.
So we did a show called An Aussie Goes Bolly, which was following the Australian cricketers around India. And at the end of 9 weeks in India, I rang him up and I said, the crew's done an amazing job. We've done all done overtime. Everyone's been great, but we need a night out. We're in Mumbai. This is one place we know we can have a good night out and so forth. So he said, no worries. I said, what sort of budget are you talking about, Jacko? And he said, oh, about $5,000. I said, no problem at all, mate. Well, I signed something hours later in rupees, right? Drunk as a skunk. Went up to my room and thought about it and then sort of woke up in the middle of the night. I was like, how many zeros and what was that? Trying to do the calculations. And eventually he rang up at about 7:30 in the morning and said, mate, good night. And I went, yeah, it was fantastic, mate. I said, you know those like huge champagne bottles that they use at the Formula One? We had heaps of those. It was great. We're just chatting away. And he goes, no, I got it, mate. Got the alarm from my credit card that went over 15,000 US.
Oh, this story's in the book along with a whole lot of
there's a whole lot of good yarns like that in the book, and there's bits of wisdom, like we spoke to our mates, uncles, grandparents, bits of advice that they live their life by, because there's a lot of blokes out there that aren't going great, so it might give them a laugh, and it might give them... This book does not need a bookmark. Chuck it down, pick it up anywhere and just grab it, and it might give you a joke or a yarn.
I love that you say keep it in the dunny. Blokosaurus is out now. Gus and Steve Worland, you two are just fabulous. Thank you so much for swinging on.
A pleasure. Thank you.